Hi friends, in my previous video, I have talked about making career through languages. And in that, I have discussed about how one can use languages and make a good career out of it, including in the field of translation, interpretation, computational linguistics, neuroscience, historical linguistics, and whatnot. Including AI as well as editing. So today I am going to introduce you to a person whose name is Mr. Vivek. Vivek is a seasoned editor and he has worked a lot and developed a career out of languages and become a very established editor. Apart from that, he has a passion to connect all editors of India at a common platform. And he is trying hard to unite all editors of India at a common platform under Indian Copy Editors Forum. And he has worked a lot in this direction. So let's meet him and understand his vision on how editing profession in India is functioning and how it is going to be organized and what are the benefits that one gets out of it. So my friends, listen to him. And try to watch this video till last, because then only you will be in a position to understand in totality how important the editing profession is. And certainly it is one of the very good promising options for people who are in languages and who want to excel in this area. So if you like the video, do comment and do share and do subscribe to our channel for latest update in language and translation business. Thanks again for being with me.
So, Vivek ji, I wanted to understand. I understand that you have been working for uniting copy editors within Indian context. And I also know that you have also visited some countries, including Canada, to understand how they function and learn from their experience. So, what is your vision about uniting editors of India?
Mr. Ravi, my vision for editors in India is for them to raise their professional standards so that they are up to the international level and are able to compete on a global level, because only then as an editor they will be in a position to earn a decent living being a full-time freelance editor. If they work as a in-house editor, then I don't think there is a problem. The salaries are pretty good. But if they want to go out for freelancing as a full-timer, then they have to look at the international market. And they will be accepted in the international market only if they are at that particular level.
Right.
So that was one reason I started Indian Copy Editors Forum after I came back from the first international conference for editors that was held in Toronto, where editors from more than 15 countries were there and they were all represented by their respective associations. But we were four from India and we didn't have a formal association backing us. So I came back and I started a Facebook group, and the idea is to share resources, to share knowledge, to help newcomers, because sometimes those newcomers, they are at a crossroad, because there are not enough formal courses in the government sector. Whatever courses are available, they are a result of private enterprise, and those are like short-term courses, which gives you a glimpse of the industry, gives you an understanding, but don't really equip you with the core skill, that is editing. Unless you know language editing, you can't really be called an editor. So a lot of people, they might be good at styling or at mechanical things, but you need to address the language, take care of it so that what goes out to the reader is understandable and conveys what the writer actually wanted to say. So that's the goal.
Right. So from, let's say, from the perspective of uniting, you know, or kind of creating a platform, a forceful platform that could serve as a reference point, number one, and also connect many editors across India. And this will perhaps create a kind of professional status, you know. So how you are planning to sync all these points in this diversified India?
Like, we are trying to organize workshops all over India. Like, we have had a few workshops at YMCA Delhi, where we cover different topics of which are of interest to editors. And we also organize online webinars. And one of our members, he is actually into training full time. So he's like giving training to corporates, and he's also open to training individuals who can take the course, and like they can watch the video lectures. And now these lectures are even available on your phone. So there is an app, you can just download the app and use it to learn whatever point is not clear to you. I would call it, it's like learning on the go. All of us, like, we spend so much of time in commuting, so we can utilize that time rather than wasting that time on watching useless videos or gossip on WhatsApp. We can use the smartphone and really become smart editors, because resources are available and they're not very costly when you compare it to the international courses that are there. So now it's only a question of willingness, only a question of taking themselves seriously, coming together and sharing their resources. But things are now available, like that much we have managed to do through Indian Copy Editors Forum. Today only we had our 61st meeting in Delhi, where we had like members from Hyderabad, Udhampur, Bengaluru and Kolkata. They had come to Delhi, and our members from Delhi NCR, they also went there. And one of our members from Bengaluru, he has published a book with a very well-known publisher called HarperCollins. The name of the book is Underage CEO. Now that book has gone into five prints already. The first print was like 5,000, and second print has been like 4,000 each. So some of our members, they had a lot of questions, like if they want to publish a book, what's the process? And the member from our Bengaluru branch, like Ganesh, he explained it in a very beautiful way, like what's the process if they want to go for traditional publishing, and what's the process if they want to go for self-publishing. So that's the kind of interaction that I'm actually happy that it's happening between authors and editors and translators. So I'm not restricting Indian Copy Editors Forum only to copy editors. I think we all need to work together. It's like a food chain where we are in a symbiotic relationship, and we need to collaborate more, because only then the opportunities that are available, we will be able to avail of them as a group.
So Vivekji, I believe that you already have done many meetings, as well as formally you have organized 61 workshops for training people in copy editing platform. So keeping all these factors into consideration, are you planning to give a formal shape to your initiative?
Yeah, we at Indian Copy Editors Forum are definitely looking into it, and a lot of members have expressed their desire that it should be a formal body, because then it will be taken more seriously by the industry, by the government and by the members themselves. Like we will get more respectability. So that option is always open, but we will need more support from the industry, from the book publishing side, basically, because that is one area in which I don't have that much of experience. So if all of us come together, it can certainly happen. And if it happens next year, it will be great, because if we can organize ourselves before the second international conference for editors that's going to be held in Montreal, Canada, then we can represent India as a formal association of editors there.
So, right, that's a very excellent idea. So, what is your appeal to the community before we close this talk?
My appeal to the community is for each member to contribute whatever they can in terms of their expertise and in terms of their time and take up some small responsibilities, and that way we can all do it very soon.
Great. Thank you, Vivekji. Thanks for your time.